Learning Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 2017, Power Pivot Formulas. Well, everything in the book is going to be podcast in here in July, August, September. Go ahead and subscribe to the watch list or the playlist top right-hand corner. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. Now, yesterday in episode 2016, I showed how we could just use the data model to take this small budget table and this large actuals table with these three joiners and create a pivot table. Today, I want to show you what you get if you pay the extra $2 a month to get the Office 365 Pro Plus and have Power Pivot. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to take these tables and I'm going to add them to the data model. The budget table is already there. I'm going to take the joiners, add that, and then back here, the region, add that, and then the calendar, I'll add that to the data model, and then finally the actuals, I'm going to add that to the data model. And I'm going to arrange these so we have the budget on the left, the joiners in the middle. And now to create the relationships, this was a lot of clicks yesterday. I'm going to go from the budget table product, the region table to region, and the region date down to date. All right, see how much faster it is to create these relationships here in the diagram view in the Power Pivot window. So that's one advantage, just a small advantage. I mean, you could still do this with the data model, but it is one small benefit. But here's the other thing that we can do. Once we get our report built, so we have our actuals and our budget, and remember we use the fields from the joiner tables to build out the pivot table. So we now have fields called budget and revenue. Boy, it'd be really nice to show a variance, and the Power Pivot tab lets us do that. Whether it's called a calculated item in 2013, or whether it's called a measure in 2010 or 2016, we can create a new measure, and this measure will be called variance, and it's going to be equal to the budget field minus the actuals field. And I can even format that as currency with zero decimal places. This is cool. Click OK. All right, see, so now for each data point, we have a budget, we have an actual, and we have a variance. Wouldn't it be nice to take the variance divided by the budget to get a variance percent? So we'll insert a new measure. And this is going to be that variance field. So the logic that I use to create the variance field is reusable, divided by the sum of budget. And this is going to be a number, but specifically a percentage with one decimal place. All right, so now I have four fields, but here's the beautiful thing. If all I want to show is the variance percentage, I don't need to show the variance, the actuals, or the budget. I can remove those fields and the logic still works. All right, so those are, let's call them helper formulas that help us get to the variance percent. I only need to keep the variance percent. Everything else stays in the data model, it's understood, it's all calculated behind the scenes, and it works beautifully. And they continue to work even if we change the shape of the pivot table. It keeps recalculating. It's a beautiful thing. Again, thanks to Rob Colley, and you should check out his book for the whole compendium of things you can do with these DAX formulas. And you can order Rob's book or my book online right now. Use that I in the top right-hand corner. All right, episode recap. So, Excel 2013 gave us the data model, but you have to pay more, an extra $2 a month, to get to the Power Pivot tab. The Office 365 Pro Plus will get you this. You can build relationships faster using the diagram view, but that's really nothing new. I mean, you could build relationships like I did yesterday just using the dialog box, but it's the calculated fields or measures that is the real benefit. It uses the DAX formula language, very powerful. Think of them like helper cells. They provide intermediate formulas, and you could build upon previous formulas. Just really, it's where the power and Power Pivot comes from. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.